Hey guys, welcome to back here at Foshi Nation. Today we're doing part 8 of the Rebuilding the L.A. Rams series here at Foshi Nation. We're replaying the Carolina Panthers here in the NFC title game. Should be a really good game, you guys. We're looking forward to it. And the big question is, can we beat this really, really good Panthers team to go to the Super Bowl? That's really the big what if right now. But yeah, so we're going to be doing that. This is our team. Not really anything's changed for the most part. We're going to change this around just more so for personal reasons than anything else. But yes, we're going to be doing this, and let's go and get started, you guys. Really, really good. There you go. Awesome. We're going to continue with that 1-2 punch of Todd Gurley and David Johnson, because that's working really well for us, you guys. We will see how this goes. I'm really optimistic that we can get this done. We just need to stick to the same formula we did last game, which got us to this point against the Green Bay Packers. Be sure to go back and watch that video. Really, really good game. Really good execute game plan. But yeah, also, be sure to comment which team you want us to see rebuild next. And you guys get to choose that. So we're going to do the top 5 answers, so be going to keep commenting. Be sure to try to get people to like your comment. More likes on that, on the comment of the team, the higher chance we'll probably get.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this
is the NFL on EA Sports. Yeah, go ahead and sit back and get your popcorn ready, as T.O. would say.
The Super Bowl on the line, everything is on the line in today's conference championship matchup. The Panthers going up against the Rams.
Very talented player.
Now let's get you out to Bank of America Stadium for this matchup.
The Panthers are back deep, waiting to return the kick.
We're going to be kicking off here first to start off this game.
The Rams ready to get this action started.
The Panthers need to get ready to do some kickoff action. Get our stuff. Kickoff here, Johnny Pepper.
And the conference championship is underway. The winner heading to the Super Bowl.
Ooh,
and he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. Here is the 2011 NFL Rookie of the Year, quarterback Cam Newton.
Careful, because he will definitely scramble on us if we did too. Ironically, Ray Rice is the starting running back for this game. I know you guys are going to stand
first down at the 29.
And
Ayers is able to read that play and make the hit.
Rams defensive coordinator, my gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield to stop a runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
The Rams defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel.
Second down and a long way to go.
Newton hooks him with Greg Olson.
He got popped after he stepped out. He's like,
And the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches.
I have a lot of good favorite Raven players and some not so favorite too.
Third down and 13.
Ooh.
Makes the catch.
Charging ahead. That's a big one.
Wide receivers in the NFL, hey, they can catch it, but also they can break tackles. What a job that time by the wide receiver.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Rice takes it out of the
eye. The
Panthers running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for a big play, what happens? He gets tackled.
Watch it. You said John Stewart tours ACL, but not in real life. Only in the game.
Well, he's in the NFL because of this, because this guy can break tackles. Good job on that play.
Nice here.
the Panthers snap it at the 26. On the money.
Did he get that first down? I'm pretty sure he did.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
The Panthers still possess the football as we begin the second quarter. The Panthers come to the line of scrimmage and show a full house. And the second quarter.
Oh, let's go. Come on, Reggie Nelson. Run, Reggie, run.
On his way.
Oh, yes, Cam Neston.
The 10.
Touchdown. Stupid score. Hashtag stupid score for Reggie Nelson.
That's the way they're taught, to be greedy. Don't be satisfied with just getting the turnover. Take it all the way back to the house.
He made it. 7-0 as we get a huge defensive touchdown there.
The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff.
That was a huge, huge play. After they were probably about to score
and
on
a touchback.
An average quarterback this kind of time, he turns into a great quarterback.
First down and 10.
Ooh, let's go. Oh,
as it goes incomplete.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
Second and 10. They'll run it here. Price is taken down at the 40.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
The Panthers are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Third and 4.
Oh, he got his goal
there. Incomplete.
This defense is on fire.
The Panthers have to punt the football.
Defense is on fire. Sure. Pretty sure you guys don't want to see here.
Looking to make a difference. Hauls in on the tackle. And a run back of about 6. The Rams line up. Been a tight first half. The score's 7-0. Two tight ends on the field here. Gets it out for the completion.
David Johnson there churning for a first down to the 33. David Johnson doesn't
do the
just
little
run
things
the football,
right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right
very
is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
He'll pick up 7 this time.
Trying to try and move me out of the way instead of the way it should.
Well, the quarterback showed off his arm strength that time, didn't he? He put the football right on the money, on a line, right into the receiver's hands.
From the gun. Gonna try and scramble now.
Okay, here you go.
The Rams now move the chains.
Sure first down yardage. Yeah, he did, but he's injured. Actually, that was the point.
The Rams have it at the 44. Slashes to the left side. Johnson's brought down after picking up just a yard.
Johnson's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Second and 9. Has the grab. Game 15. The Rams decide to take a timeout here, leaving them with only 1. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. The Panthers with a nickel look here on defense. Out of the shotgun. Scrambling out of the pocket.
Okay, there you go. Good catch by Corbin to get us inside the red zone there. We're officially in the zone.
The best way to keep the other offense on the sidelines is just keep marching down the field and picking up those first downs. What a good job by the offense.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Rams team official. At this point, the medical staff is going to hold him out of this one with what they're still just calling an upper body injury. So, guys, he's out for the day. Back to you.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. First and goal.
Wide open, the Rams put up six. Another touchdown.
Getting close to the half, and they're giving their opponents a lot to talk about in the locker room.
Yeah, they are putting some kind of whipping on them here early in the game. I'll just say this for the defensive side that's losing. It's been terrible. So go in there at halftime, change what you're doing, and get back in this game.
And no return as this goes for a touchback. The Panthers didn't get much out of that last drive, so now here they come again on offense. I'm sure they're going to be a little bit more of an urgency to the offense this time.
Well, I'll just say this to you, Jim Pants. I sure hope so. After that last drive, that was just too generic. Wasn't very well thought out, and they got to change what they're doing on the offensive side.
Got to give that defense a little credit, though, don't you?
Well, yeah, the defense did its job, but it up pretty easy.
Plays against the former running back.
And we'll be back to Charlotte after the break for the start of the third quarter. Welcome back, folks. Jim Nance and Bill Sims here at Bank of America Stadium for the call as the second half is about to get underway. That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. The Rams take the field here in the second half, looking to extend their lead in this one, partner.
Yeah, you know what you do if halftime is over. You come out of here, you're not sure what the new game plan is going to be, but feel your way into the game. Don't take a chance early and turn the football over.
Double tight end formation. Second down and 10. Flag. Baldwin's got it. And a pass had some heat on it.
First down, depending on who, what that flag is on.
Offside.
Offside on the defense. I'll take it.
Bill declined the penalty and let the play stand. First down at the 38. Wide to the left. Johnson's tackled down at the 39.
Johnson's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game. The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
It's out of the pocket.
Oh, there he goes.
Two hands on the football and has the catch. Brought down at the 29. That's his third catch of the day.
That's a nice play at that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That's a great feeling.
This play set up by the long gainer, running right through the trenches. Met by Davis that time.
Johnson is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Best part of this is we can run off as much time as we want.
The Rams snap it up at the 26. The catch is made.
Another good catcher. This reliable hands so that he possesses.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
First and 10. Johnson's taking the handoff.
To the 10-yard line. That's going to be under the third.
The Rams have the football as the fourth quarter gets started.
They haven't given up any points in about almost two games if we can get.
The final quarter begins with this snap. And now he'll take off. Touchdown, St. Louis Rams. That's his second touchdown today. And with less than a quarter to play, it's going to be very difficult to catch them at this point.
Yeah, the chances of a comeback have almost gone to impossible. But I'll say this on the offensive side. Don't take any chances and see if you can just find a way to march down the field to score to keep this game going.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20.
They went back to 1970. As their new regime with Los Angeles Rams, not the old regime. They're going to change the
And Rice is lined up directly behind the quarterback here. First down at the 20. The Panthers get a first down.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
Apparently they lost the Cody Brown free agency last season. And also Ted Ginn Jr. signed from another team. Pretty sure it was
on. The Panthers take it from the 33. That's Newton over to Wilson for the catch. That's another reception given to.
There is nothing like having a great tight end in your offense now. There's so many things you can do with them. Remember, they're in the middle of the field. They can go down the middle. They can go outside. They can go short. They can go across. They can go out. Tough to cover the tight ends in this league now.
First down at the 50. He's got the catch.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity right on target.
Greg Olsen here again.
Second down and 8. Complete to Greg Olsen.
Well, if you guard the tight end close, it sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms, they can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance, they get it done.
Newton's now completed 4 in a row.
Ooh,
and
oh,
there's
good
a drop
right there.
I mean,
that's
right,
like cover 2 when they're in that formation.
Advancing it now inside the 40.
Same formation again.
Rice lines up as the single back here. Looking across the middle, and he's tackled down after picking up the first. They'll go right to the hurry up, won't use a timeout here. First and 10. Newton to Olsen. Williams there to make the stop. The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. They're going to the hurry up, back to the line. Second down, 2 to go. He'll throw it over the middle.
And that's a little common pass by Cam Newton.
This is third down. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle.
The Panthers go with the pass that time on third and short. The defense was ready, and they stopped the pass. Now we have a fourth down situation.
The give this time to the fullback. This drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. What a drive this has been. Won't huddle now. Gonna conserve the timeout and rush back to the line. The Panthers snap it at the 26.
Gains
13. This will be the offense's 12th play of the drive. Time continues to tick away as they'll rush back to the line.
Bad pass. He had him there, too. 4th and 8 coming up.
The offense is on the field on 4th and 8. Newton's alone in the backfield. Out of the shotgun formation. He's wide open for the grab. The Panthers signal for a timeout. They have 2 remaining.
The score here is not really going to do anything for them at this point in the game. The game is over.
Goal line defense on the field. It's Harris with the sack. The offense stops the clock right away with a timeout. And now, getting set for the 15th play of the drive. The Panthers at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. 2nd down and 11. Can't find the target, and it's incomplete.
Tim, I love these situations. Third and goal, what are they going to call? They're going to run the football, they're going to go with the pass, and if it is a pass, I would look for something quick.
Third and 11.
Ooh,
and it's back down
by Rolando McClain. Did not allow anything.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
Ooh, oh,
makes
he
the
gets
catch
his
in the end zone. Touchdown. The head coach decides he wants to be the aggressor in this situation. On fourth and goal, he goes for it. Nice play call that time. The Rams are ready to return the kick.
They've accepted their fate.
Tackles made. They started their practice back in July, training camps all through the regular season. This was the goal from the beginning, to advance to the Super Bowl, and they have done so today with their win in the NFC title game.
So we have a conference champion and the